very simple in the beginning. I still remember, and I still have to laugh about it. This guy delivered the goods 1 week too late. And so I asked for discount, because my customers also will ask for discount if we deliver too late. And then he say, why? I should upcharge you, because it seems you still need the goods.
Welcome to a new episode of the Benjam CL Initiative. In front of me today, Jeroen Herrems.
We are running here in Handbag Factory. This area where I'm living is a handbag city. There's a huge amount of handbag factories around. So we have an own factory, but we also work with a lot of other factories around us together. 2017, yeah, we opened a factory in Myanmar. Now in Myanmar, the first factory is 3,500 square meter with about 600 workers. And the second factory just opened, is about double size, about 6,000 square meter. It is just every time you add a little bit more load in your backpack, you know?
And you're just, your backpack.
Yeah. And then you keep on walking and you become stronger and stronger. This is more how I see it. Very big advantage is here that you can act incredible quickly. To open here our own sample room, but also have the market here. If our customers come with one idea or with a photo, they look for something similar, then within the same day we can find it. We can find the special hardware what they want, or the special lock, or the special material what they want.
It's actually because the supply chain here is extremely big, but beside that is also the availability of direct labor to create samples, direct labor to create certain new fabrics or to deliver directly parts to make the bag.
But in Holland, if you go to a company and you want something from them, then you make an appointment to arrange something or to discuss something. But actually here, it is you just walk in, or you just go there and you call them. I'm at the gate now. Or where are you? Oh, you are not. You are not inside. Tell your employees I am here now. So they will help you immediately. They will arrange immediately.
In our countries, we commit to the responsibility of what we sell and say.
Correct.
And here, you commit to a cooperation in which you need to be willing to help each other out at the moment that there are problems.
Yes, and yes, exactly. Willing. Because you also know, we as a Laowai in China, as a foreigner in China, we simply don't get the best prices. Even I am here, if I need this bottle empty to fill something in, I don't get the same price as a Chinese.
Never.
For sure, we pay more. So, but if I have the right Guangxi and have a good relationship with the guy, and I always go with him to the KTV and we can drink weekly, for example, together, then I get the same price or even a better price. And here's a huge market with a lot of suppliers, and actually many suppliers are selling the same. So you can only by experience you know which one is reliable, which one is good and which one is not good. Quality issues is the thickness.
Okay.
You agree a kind of thickness and they make it slightly thinner. Another issue is that every raw material should be 40 yards. There's a kind of rule in this city. And simply they make it 39.5 yards. So every roll they cut half yard material. Very simple. In the beginning, I still remember, and I still have to laugh about it. This guy delivered the goods 1 week too late. And so I asked for discount, because my customers also will ask for discount if we deliver too late. And then he say, why? I should upcharge you, because it seems you still need the goods. this kind of thinking from why I should give you discount if you so strongly need the goods. Many suppliers here, they're not thinking in long term, they are thinking in short term.
You buy the raw materials and they have been sent to Myanmar.
Yes.
And then there they are assembled, right?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
Even the machines coming from here. The Chinese knowledge is everything in Myanmar. So actually the Burmese people, they cannot run or set up this factory without the knowledge from China. It is all the Chinese, they come there to live, but there is many suppliers for machines, for decoration, even for internet. This is, by the way, illegal internet, but that is so funny from Chinese people, where they can make money, they make money. But yes, everything, all the suppliers are Chinese. So I was not able in Myanmar to set up the factory, to decorate the factory, to start the factory without the Chinese society there.
You know, the shift of trade in the world is that there are some sectors going out of China to, for example, Myanmar to be produced, right? But what is, in my eyes, a really significant, people don't think about, is actually that it are the Chinese going out of China mostly. So that means you will still, even if you don't buy anymore in China, you will still deal with a lot of Chinese suppliers
or
in the Chinese business model. So sometimes the question is asked, like, okay, should you still focus on China? Well, actually, if you have the knowledge of China, you will be also able to manage everything well enough in the other countries.
Yeah, 100% correct. This is also what I thought when I just go to Myanmar and we met some Chinese people, business people there. Then we thought immediately, wow, if I came there from Holland as a Dutchman to Myanmar, I was not able to do this. This is really, I can say, really unique for all the people living, doing business in China, living in China, can speak some basic Chinese. Then the world is so much bigger than only China. That you really have to do a good research, or you really have to blind jump in it as I did. I think you should be willing to go very deep.
And to go very deep means if things go wrong.
Go wrong, that it can be entered without situation, without money.
Contributed to our success actually is that we always try to learn from everything that went wrong, and also want to adapt to the Chinese culture.